In this segment, we are going to talk about most commonly used palettes on the right side of the screen. The palettes are important features in Adobe Photoshop. They allow you to monitor and adjust your work, which was demonstrated a number of times in the Toolbox section. Before we begin exploring palettes one by one, let's go over common functions first. By default, each window has more than one palette. You can see by number of tabs in the window. To activate a hidden palette, simply click on the respective tab. Use the Expand Collapse icon if necessary to display or hide the full window. In addition, windows can be rearranged. To do so, click and drag on the top of the window to tear it off. To add, click and drag to the desired place, either at the bottom, top, or in the middle. Wait for the blue highlight and release the mouse. And finally, you can expand and collapse the entire row of windows by clicking on double arrow at the top. If you need to access any specific palette, simply click on the respective icon to bring it up. Click on icon again to close, or use double arrows. This is especially useful if you have limited screen area. In addition, palettes can be removed from and added to windows individually. To remove a palette, simply click on the X icon in the tab. To add the palette, go to Window menu and choose the desired palette from the list. Note that they are listed in the alphabetical order, and active palettes will have check marks next to them. Now I have my navigator back, and let's bring back history. And final feature is option menu unique to each palette. To access, click on the palette menu button located right below the close window icon. Now let's go back to the default workspace and explore each palette one by one. Navigator contains a thumbnail preview of your document. A red rectangle called the proxy view surrounds the currently visible area in the document. You can change the view of the document by dragging the proxy view around the thumbnail. This palette can also be used to zoom in and out using the slider at the bottom. Or enter in a specific magnification value. Histogram displays color intensity level in your document. It is a good feature if you are a photographer. As a fashion designer, I don't use it at all, so I'm going to remove this palette from the window. Info palette displays basic information related to the active document and the tool in use. As I move a cursor over my document, I can spot the color. You could see how RGB and CMYK values are changing. I can also see axis placement of my cursor. You could see how X and Y values are changing. If I were to use the selection tool, I could see width and height of my current selection. And right below the dimensions, InfoPalette displays your current document size. In the final section, you'll find tips on how to use currently selected tool. I'm working with selection tool right now, so it says draw rectangular selection or move selection outline. Use Shift, Option, and Command for additional options. To customize the palette, click on the option icon in the top right and select palette options. First color readout mode, I'm going to keep it actual color. Since I'm working in RGB anyway, it will display RGB values, and if I decided to switch to a different mode, info palette will change accordingly. The second color readout I'm going to set to opacity. I use opacity often, and this option will help me to remember the settings if I want to recreate the transparency. You can see how opacity information changes as I roll my cursor over to different parts of the document. You can set your rulers to different units. Sometimes when I work with splats in Photoshop, I use centimeters for better precision. If I were to work on the web graphics, I'll use pixels. But generally, I prefer to stay with inches. In the status information section, I will uncheck document size. If I need it, I can see the size at the bottom of my document. I'd rather have document dimensions instead. That provides me with the resolution settings and number of pixels in my document. I'll check current tool as well, keep show tool hints, and click OK. Although I don't have info palette active when I work, I refer to it once in a while, so I will definitely keep it in the window.